Since the post-Iron Age, Siberia is an immense space, the most part of which is covered with forest. Covered with forests, varying from deciduous and mixed one to the black coniferous taiga. In such landscape conditions, localization of historical objects, temporal camps, settlements of hunters and fishermen, and even such large objects as Russian towns can be a serious and intractable problem. This is Siberia. The Slavic tradition of development of forest regions from Moravia and Odra through Novgorod continued in founding Russian towns and lesser settlements during colonization of Siberia in the late 17th centuries. The settlements are known from written sources and old maps, but the locations are quite vague and maybe only guidelines for topographical bindings. Archaeological sources significantly influence the solution of the localization problem because they are ruins of real historical sites and have a clear topographic reference. On the other hand, attribution of the excavated sites and their identification with the written and image data is a great difficulty as well. Application of geophysical methods is much reduced in densely forest and often swampy taiga, as well as in detecting early cultural strata of modern cities due to high anthropogenic pressure. In such cases, the main method of localization is comparative analysis of data from various sources, which allow detecting the most probable sites for the subsequent excavation. The first Russian astroks, forts which were rather small fortified towns in the zone of the southern taiga in western Siberia were founded in Narym region. The specificity of natural and geographical condition of the region is in high density of the forest as well as in the presence of the world's largest Vasugan swamps and the ramified river network with the length of more than 1,000 kilometers. By the time the Russians appeared, the population density in the Narym region was less than one person per 10 square kilometers. The largest Russian forts in the province are Narym and Ketsk. Let us analyze the reasons. In the first half of the 17th century, they changed their location more than five times, preserving the name and the continuity of their functions. Let us analyze the reasons for their displacement and special geographical criteria corresponding to the task of functioning of Russian forts in the Narym region in different periods. The initial priority was the political factor. Fortified points were located near the aboriginal settlements. A second factor. At the start, Russians did not know the local natural features and placed their forts on the sites which were flooded in the springs. And that's why they have to move forts to a new place. The third. As the local population entered to the Russian state, the main task was the annual gathering of Yesak, It is a tribute info from the native. That's why it was very important to choose the right location to ensure communication with Yisak districts. The fourth, the formation of permanent Russian population made a priority in placement is a land suitable for tillage. In this region, it's forest glades on high river banks. For that reason, Ketsk moved from the upper reaches of the Ket River to the area of the modern village of Ket. Fifth, relocation of the forts were influenced by the need to uniform the distribution of transshipment and customs centers, which controlled migration of trade people. And the last, adjustment of the fort's location were made to the frequent change of the riverbeds. The location of Narym and Ketsk up till now are not detected because in the Taiga wetlands it is extremely difficult to find old town vestiges. Several archaeological explorations were not very successful. To narrow the area of search, it is necessary to use data of written and graphic sources. But the task faces many difficulties. The first maps appeared only in the second half of the 17th century, and they did not reflect the relocations, and often use outdated information. They must be used with great caution. Maps of the 17th and 18th centuries are valuable sources, but they need correction to the modern geographical situation. The analysis of hydronyms is of particular importance for the localizations and moving of the towns. Let us consider another type of situation, search for foundation places of historical cities that existed now. The example of Tomsk is just right. It is one of the earliest Siberian towns founded in 1604. Until the 90s, it was believed that Tomsk was initially built on the southern cape of the Voskresenskaya mountain. Images of original Tomsk did not survive. We have only description of it of 1627, but location oriented very relative and have such geographical objects as Tom River, the Ushaika River, and the swamp. But the contemporary analysis has shown that the document data are inaccurate. And it is impossible to localize initial Tomsk based only by the data of this document. In 1648, Tomsk town was rebuilt and relocated on new place. It is the southern cape of Voskresenskaya mountain. Evidence has survived in several 18th century plans, panoramic pictures, and the description by Gerhard Friedrich Miller. However, the sources give only approximate and incorrect information about the design of the fortification, its internal construction and configuration, and even the size of the Kremlin. It is clearly seen when combining plans, and the situation is explained by the low geometric accuracy of the 18th century maps, errors in topographical survey of the time, and errors in scaling. The most complete picture of Tomsk in the second half of the 17th century is given by the archaeological research, as a result of which is the reconstruction of Kremlin's defensive walls and Voivoda mansion. Tomsk of the first half of the 17th century gives a productive example of landscape analysis. In the collaboration of the swamps researcher Asintseva, there was made an investigation which gave a new reading to the written sources and a reasonable hypothesis for the most suitable place for town of that time. It was very possible situated on the northern cape of the Voskresenskaya mountain. However, initial Tomsk might be located on the Tom High River bank at the confluence of the Mushaika and Tom rivers. But these versions need to be proved or disproved by further archaeological research. So, at the conclusion, the search and localization of olden settlements in changed cultivated landscape or in the taiga is the most promising when using a multi-type sources complex and interdisciplinary approach. It allows determining the most likely areas of object occurrence for subsequent excavation. The principle of historical object localization worked out for Siberian Russian towns are methodologically applicable to search for archaeological monuments of various epochs and in forest zones in other territories. Thank you very much for the attention.